You know, our country's in a mess, and some people think it's too late to turn things around. A lot of people are saying, you know, I think we've gone too far. I don't think we can ever turn this thing around. Another president's not going to do it. The leadership's so poor, it doesn't really matter. It's not, nothing's going to change. And, you know, them things may be true when it comes to politics, but I want to explain this to you today. You were not put here to try to maintain what you have. You were not put here to try to fit in and just keep things going the way they're supposed to go. We're not put here to be prosperous. We're not put here to be all about ourselves, even though it's good to have money. It's good to have prosperity. It's good to have what you need, no doubt about it. But we are put here to be a witness for God. And we need to understand this today as a child of God. Things are bad, and the signs of the times are here, the end times, but God does not want us looking for a sign of what to do. He has already given us that sign of what to do, and it's found in Matthew, the 12th chapter. Jesus told the religious people, the Pharisees and scribes, they said, "Master, we would see a sign from thee." And he said, "An evil and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall no sign be given to it but the sign of the prophet Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. The men of Nineveh shall rise up in judgment with this generation and shall condemn it, because they repented at the preaching of Jonah. And behold, a greater than Jonah is here." Now what he was talking about is, he's the Christ, the Son of the living God. He's the greatest thing that's ever stepped foot on this planet. And he was going to the cross and going to shed his blood and die. And 3 days and three nights he'd be in the earth, and he'd walk out of that tomb the third day, victorious over death, hell, and the grave. And that's the sign. That's the gospel. That's the good news that we're to proclaim. And what's wrong with our country today and around the world is we're not proclaiming the gospel like we should be. That's the only thing that would change man. That's the only thing that can change a man's heart, change a man's direction. That's the only thing that can save today. It's the only way to God. He says, Jesus said, "I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father but by me." But I want to go a little deeper with this, because Jesus referenced Jonah. And we know he referenced Jonah as a sign, and he was 3 days and three nights in the belly of a whale. But there's a little bit more to Jonah's story. See, Jonah was called by God to go to a people that he didn't like. He didn't like them. He didn't want anything to do with them. Many Christians today have gotten to a place where we look at the wickedness in our country and wicked people, and instead of loving them and going to them in love and preaching truth to them, we decide, no, we want them to be destroyed. We just don't need them around us. Let God have them. Let God judge them. Let God do what he's going to do. That's not what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to have love for one another, love for a different race, love for a different person, love for those people that believe differently, have a different religion. And how do you truly love somebody? Not by being tolerant and saying, "Oh, let's all just get along and hold hands." No, by telling them the truth. Jesus is the truth, and without him you can't be saved. Without Christ you can't go to heaven. If you love somebody, you tell them the truth. If you want to just get along and everybody be happy in this life, then just be tolerant. There's nothing wrong with getting along. There's nothing wrong with trying to have peace. But listen, this life is a vapor. And when you leave here, the only thing that's going to matter is, are you saved or not? Your 401k won't matter. Your savings account, where you vacationed at, how great you kept in shape, none of that will matter. What will matter is your soul right with God? Are you saved today? And Jonah ran from God. He did not want to go to the people that God had told him to go to and tell them about God's wanting to spare them if they will repent. And so he ran. Listen, every time you run from God, I don't care who you are, when you run from God, you will run, you will go down. It always leads down. When we turn from him, we turn our back on God, it leads, we go to despair. You leave peace and joy. It always goes down. Jonah went down to Joppa. He bought a ticket and went down into the ship. He went down into the bottom of the ship running from God. We know that God prepared a storm that came, and then they threw him overboard because Jonah said, "This storm's for me. I'm a Hebrew. I'm running from God. I'm disobedient. Throw me overboard and the storm will subside." They threw him overboard, so he went down into the sea. A fish or a whale swallowed him and took him down to the depths of the ocean. So when he ran from God, everywhere he went down. And you know, even though he was going down and he was running from God in disobedience, God still used Jonah. Why? Because the power of God. See, it ain't about you. It ain't about me. It's about the power of God coming upon us. If God's called you and using you and sending you, then God will accomplish his will through your life if you will serve him. Jonah reached those men on the ship because when they threw him overboard, they all made vows to God and they acknowledged the Lord. And so that was his first witness, and he didn't even know about it. He was out in the ocean being swallowed by fish while the men were repenting and turning to God. And we know that when he was in the bottom of that sea, in that fish's belly, that he repented and God caused that fish to vomit him up. And he hit the ground running. He went into Nineveh and he preached repentance. And the whole town repented and turned to God. That can happen in America. Some of y'all think, well, you know, you're religious fanatic, you're crazy. Listen, you know what? If believing this makes me fanatical, if believing this makes me like that, then yes, I am. You know why? Because I believe it from cover to cover. I believe He has all power and all glory. And I believe if we will honor Him and do what He's told us to do and go and be a witness, that lives will be changed. The drunk will be set free from alcohol. Drug addicts will come out of that without no side effects and they'll be completely delivered. Prostitutes and pimps will come off the street. People that have all these problems in their life will be set free. Anxiety will be lifted. Depression will be gone from people's lives if they will simply turn to the cross of Jesus Christ. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And that's all that matters today. Has America gone too far? Is it too late? Absolutely not. It's never too late. As long as there's breath in your body and you have a heartbeat, God will use you today. Get busy reaching the lost. That's what we're called to do. And until next time, let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in His sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen.